بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد أحبتي في الله was reflecting on the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah where Allah تبارك وتعالى says في كتاب الكريم mentioning a dua and this is a dua of the righteous that the righteous should say. And it is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, A'udhu billahi an akuna min al-jahineen. And I seek refuge in Allah from being of the jahileen, from being of those who are ignorant. And the reason that made me reflect upon this is I was thinking that ignorance has many different levels and has many different types, many different levels of ignorance, of jahil, and many different levels or many different types of ignorance. And one of the types of ignorance, the one that I want to kind of focus on here, is not just not knowing about your religion. That is very very important for us to realize the importance of seeking Islamic knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that those who fear him the most are the ulama. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, mentions all throughout the Quran the importance of knowing tawheed and knowing the meaning of la ilaha illallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in kitab al-kareem, fa'lam annahu la ilaha illallah wa astaghfir li dhanbik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and know, and this is in the imperative form. It's a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهِ إِلَّا There is no God worthy of worship except Allah. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ And seek forgiveness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands you with tawheed, commands you with understanding tawheed, commands you with tamassuk bi tawheed and practicing tawheed. And he, tabarak wa ta'ala, at the same time, then says, and seek forgiveness. Because you're going to have shortcomings in your knowledge. You're going to have shortcomings in your practice. You're going to have shortcomings even in your understanding of tawheed. And Iman. So it's very important to understand that. And we know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also extolled the virtues of Islamic knowledge. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man yaradallahu bi khayrin yafaqahu fid din," whenever Allah wants good for a person, he gives him fiqh. He gives him understanding of the religion. So we know that that's imperative, that we have fiqh fi deen, that we have understanding of the religion, so that way we can practice properly. That's the point. It's not to be called an alim. It's not to be called a qari, a person of knowledge, a person who is a reciter of the Quran. However, it's in order to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's in order to have the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's a sign that Allah loves you when he gives you some understanding of the religion. And likewise, it is the path in Sabil al-Mu'mineen, and it's the path of Jannah. It's the path of Jannah. It's the path that will get you to paradise. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sallaka tariqan yaltalmasahu bihi ilman, sahhalallahu lahu tariqan ila jannah." Whoever traverses the path of knowledge, Allah will make easy for him the path to paradise. And we've mentioned this countless times, so maybe by now some of the people who listen will know this simple athar of the Salaf, that some of the Salaf used to say, that talab al-ilm, talab al-jannah, that seeking knowledge is seeking paradise. Talab al-ilm, talab al-jannah, seeking knowledge is seeking paradise. So it doesn't mean seeking knowledge of being a doctor, seeking knowledge of being a lawyer, seeking knowledge of being an Uber driver, seeking knowledge of being a muhandis, an engineer, but it means talab al-ilm, meaning talab al-ilm al-shar. It means seeking knowledge of the shar. And so this is a call to myself to get back on track, get back in the books, get back with the ulama, listening, And increasing my knowledge and making revision. Because if you don't make revision, you forget. Now, let's get back to what we're talking about. The main point I wanted to mention, and what I was reflecting on when I thought about this ayah, and sometimes I mention when I see so much ignorance from some of my brothers and sisters, when they're speaking ignorance, talking, bragging about sins, and this is in Saudi Arabia I'm talking about. I'm not even talking about being in the West. But what I see from some of the people I'm around at times, when they're saying ignorant stuff, when they're praising sin and praising wanting to come to America and indulge in sins. Oh, Usted, I want to go to Las Vegas. Oh, Usted, you know, Florida, I went to Florida and it was banging. I went to here and I went to here. Sin this and sin this. When they are praising this, sometimes I say to myself, and I say it out loud, I say, I'ud be lying in a kuna min al jahilin. And I seek refuge in Allah from being of the jahilin, being of the ignorant. The type of ignorance, ahabati fillah, that I'm discussing here, that I want to discuss, and I'm going to be very brief because I know I've taken up a lot of your time, is that we're talking about the ignorance of not practicing. This is one of the scariest things. It's sufficient enough where we see a lot of our brothers and sisters who don't have any desire for knowledge. So then they just remain ignorant, and they don't listen and they don't do anything to better their Islam and their religion. But what I'm talking about, ahabati fillah, I'm talking about knowing some knowledge and not practicing. All of us know that zina is haram. All of us know, I think, without a doubt, even a new Muslim, they know that alcohol and drugs are muharram, but yet we indulge in those major sins. We know many of those things, and sometimes we feel sorrow before we're going to do it, and we feel sorrow when we're doing it, perhaps, and we feel sorry after, but we still did it, and we still do it. And so this is very important, because when you're in the West, you see that there's much more access to this. When you're in some countries, and even this is in many Muslim countries, unfortunately, but in some countries, it's difficult to get those sins. So that helps you. The society itself, the culture, and the hukum, the Sharia rulings that the governments implement, this helps you. This is an assistance for you to keep you away from even being tempted, because it's not accessible even. But when you're in a society where it's open and it's all around you, it can be very difficult to abstain. And you can fall into those sins easily if you are one who is tempted by those things. So the jahil, the ignorance I'm referring to, is the one who really doesn't know that Allah is watching him or her. The one who really doesn't know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness over all of our affairs. That they know it on their tongue. They can recite to you the three types of tawheed, and maybe they can even talk about it intricately. But where is their iman? Because they can do that, and at the same time, you'll find them in the club. At the same time, you'll find them in the strip joint. At the same time, they will be the stripper and know this. And these are not strange scenarios. These are real scenarios that we find these type of major sins sometimes amongst our brothers and sisters. And may Allah forgive us and forgive them. May Allah guide us and guide them, because we are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we're in need of removing that true jahil, that true ignorance from ourselves, which is clouding our iman, which is clouding our progress as human beings. Because when you look at it, when we reflect, we see that sins hold us back from so much progress in our lives. And that may seem strange to people, but really, because we know so many people who are in disbelief, who have so much in the dunya. And we know people who are even Muslim, who are indulged and open about major sins, but yet it seems like they're successful. But the one of iman, the person who has some iman and is cognizant, at least to a greater or lesser extent, he or she realizes those sins impede their progress. Meaning, for example, the one who wants to seek knowledge. If you're in major sins, you're not really going to be able to memorize like that, and you will be forgetful. You will forget, because while you should be making revision, you'll be watching and touching and drinking and smelling the muharram and smoking the muharram. You'll be indulging those sins, and those sins in and of themselves, it's amazing. I don't know the physiology of those sins, but we do know a bit about the psychology. That when you're indulged in that munkarat and you know that it's sin, it's going to affect you. It's going to affect you psychologically. It's going to affect you mentally, and you're going to feel sorrow, and you're not going to be as productive. You're not going to be as progressive in your life, and it will impair, of course, your memorization. It will impair your practice. How can you make Qiyam al-Layl if you're at the club? It's very difficult. Those things, they don't go together. So this is the type of ignorance I'm talking about. The ignorance which impedes you from practicing. The ignorance from really knowing that Allah is watching you, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with ihsan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith of Jibreel, alayhi salatu wa salam, قال, when he was asked about ihsan, قال, أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. The Prophet alayhi afdal salatu wasalam said, when he was asked about ihsan from the angel Jibreel, he said, ihsan, he says, it is an ta'budullah, it is to worship Allah, ka'annaka tara, as if you see him. فَإِن لَمْ تُكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكُ. And the fact that you can't see him, know that he sees you. So the one who's worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with ihsan, it's impossible for him to be doing those types of munkar. Why? Because how is it possible that you know that you're worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing that he sees you, fearing him, you know, bowing before your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, but then at the same time, you can watch the most evilest things, do the most evil of sins, the major sins, without even having any shame. Without any having any shame. Even if it's behind closed doors, because you know the one who has ihsan, he knows that Allah is watching him. Similarly to the way he knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees him when he is praying, that Allah sees you when you're sinning. So this is the type of, this is the level of iman we want to get, and this is the type of ignorance that we want to remove from our lives, and we want to become closer to Allah. May Allah bless us with tawfiq. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.